The Orthodox side said that the apostles of Jesus are the ones who know the truth. This became a very important teaching in Orthodox Christianity. In Orthodox Christianity, it was taught that the leaders of the current churches, say in the year 180 when Irenaeus is writing, the leaders of the churches were appointed by people who were appointed by people who were appointed by the apostles of Jesus. And so God sent Jesus. Jesus had his apostles. His apostles appointed the leaders of the churches who appointed their successors, who appointed their successors. You see, I mean, you still have this in the Roman Catholic structure where the Pope ultimately can trace his line all the way back to Peter, the right-hand man of Jesus. Well, the Orthodox thought that the apostles who were with Jesus during his lifetime were obviously the ones who understood the truth. And so if you have writings that the apostles wrote, then if you follow those writings, then you're right. And if the apostles appointed leaders of the churches, then you should follow what the leaders of the churches say. The apostles were the ones who know. That's why you get so many apostolic writings in early Christianity. You get all sorts of books that claim to be written by Peter, or by James, or by John, or name your apostle. Why? In fact, these people didn't write these books. Simon Peter did not write any books. We, in the New Testament, we have two books, the first Peter and second Peter, that claim to be written by Peter. Outside the New Testament, we have a Gospel of Peter. We have three apocalypses of Peter. Writing books in the name of Peter was a cottage industry in early Christianity. And the reality is, Peter didn't write any of them, and for a very good reason, because Peter didn't know how to write. Peter was a lower-class Aramaic-speaking fisherman from the rural area of Galilee who never went to school. He certainly could not write. So why do you have all these books claiming to be written by Peter? Because the apostles are the ones who know, and if you write a book and you're a nobody, then nobody's going to read your book. But if you're a nobody and you write a book and you sign it Peter, then Christians might read it. And so you claim to be Peter. In other words, you lie about it. And people did that a lot. So this is all predicated on the idea that the apostles of Jesus are the ones in the know, but according to the Gospel of Judas, it's not that way at all. The apostles of Jesus don't understand him. They are ignorant. Judas is the only one who has an inkling of what's going on. In the Orthodox view, Judas was the worst and the heinous apostle, the betrayer, the one who is condemned for all time, but not according to the Gospel of Judas. Judas, in this gospel, is the one apostle who actually knew who Jesus was, where he came from, and he knew Jesus' private revelation that Jesus gave to him. This is why I'm calling the Lost Gospel of Judas an alternative vision of Christianity.